Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on calculation of Euler's load for a given column. Here is the question. A hollow steel tube of 200 mm external diameter and 25 mm thick. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data. So here, the first thing which is given is that it is a hollow steel tube. Of 200 mm external diameter, so external diameter I'll keep it as capital D, and 25 mm thick, so thickness is 25. Next, it is 4 meter long, length of the column is 4 meter, so that becomes 4000 mm, and it is used as a column. If one end is fixed and the other end is hinged, so I'll write this condition that one end is fixed and other end is hinged. Find the load the column can carry. Use Euler's formula. It means here we have to find the load carried by the column by using Euler's formula. So that would be called as Euler's load, denoted by P suffix E, and factor of safety is given as 2. So whenever the factor of safety is given, in that case the Euler's load which we are going to find out, that would be converted into a safe load. That is P safe. So now with this much data available, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now in the solution, first I'll draw the diagram. Here I'm drawing the hollow cross section. Now this is the hollow cross section of the column, and here is the x and y axis. Now in the problem, they have given the external diameter and thickness. So this is the external diameter, denoted by capital D, and thickness of the column is given. So here if I project this, so this T is the thickness of column. Now from this capital D and thickness, we can calculate the internal diameter of the hollow column, and for that I'll write down, since internal diameter I'll denote it as small d, it is equal to your external diameter is capital D minus thickness is on one side, it is there on the other side as well. So minus 2t twice into thickness. So therefore small d will be equal to capital D, it is 200, minus 2 into small t, that is 25. So therefore the inner diameter comes out to be 150 mm. So this is the internal diameter, small d. Now after that, it was given that if one end is fixed and the other end is hinged. Now I am going to use this condition, one end is fixed and other end is hinged. I'll draw it and explain that if we have a column, I am drawing this line which indicates the total height of the column. Now one end of the column is hinged, the other end is fixed. This is the total length of the column, which here it is given as 4 meter. Next. Now for such a column, if it is subjected to load which is compressive, then because of the action of this load, the column will try to buckle, it will try to bend. And how it will bend? From the hinge support, it will start bending from here and it will stop ahead of the fixed end. Means bending of the column will not continue up to the fixed end, it will stop before that. So here is the length of the column which is bending, and this length of the column is the effective length. Effective length of the column is that length which takes part in the actual bending. So here we have to even note down this effective length. So here I'll start the problem. The question was to find the Euler's load. So since Euler's crippling load, it is also called as Euler's buckling load. So Euler's crippling load is given by P suffix E is equal to pi square E I minimum upon effective length square. This is the Euler's formula. I'll keep it as equation number 1. Now, in the Euler's formula, we need to have values of all things here. That is, we should have what is the value of E, I minimum and effective length. So therefore, first of all, it is given that here we have a steel column, hollow steel. So for that, we can assume the value of capital E. I'll write down, assuming Young's modulus for column material as capital E is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. So this is the Young's modulus we are assuming for steel. Next, I minimum is the minimum moment of inertia, and first is effective length. So I'll calculate effective length. I'll say that therefore for one end hinged and other end fixed, effective length is given by L suffix E is equal to L by root 2. This is the general formula to calculate the effective length for one end of the column hinged and the other end fixed. So therefore, here I'll get effective length is equal to the total length of the column, it is 4000 mm divided by root 2. So effective length comes out to be 2828.43 mm. Now once we know the effective length, after this we can start calculating the minimum moment of inertia. So now once we have got effective length, now I'll go for the calculation of I minimum. Since minimum moment of inertia is given by I minimum is equal to IXX and it is also equal to IYY. So I minimum is the minimum moment of inertia, and if we see that for a hollow circular section, moment of inertia about X and Y will have same value. So here I minimum is equal to IXX and IYY. So therefore, I minimum is equal to pi by 64 capital D raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4. That is here in the moment of inertia formula, we have pi by 64 external diameter raised to 4 minus internal diameter raised to 4. Putting the values here, capital D is 200, small d is 150. So here I am getting I minimum. My answer is 53.69 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Now after getting this I minimum, we can say that putting all values in equation number 1 will give us the Euler's load. So therefore, put all values in equation number 1. So we have Euler's load is equal to pi square, E is 2 into 10 raised to 5, which we have assumed. So it is pi square E into I minimum, which is 53.69 into 10 raised to 6, divided by effective length square. Effective length was, it was 2828.43 square. So therefore, Euler's load will be 13.25 into 10 raised to 6 Newton, or 13.25 into 10 raised to 3 kilonewton, because we have divided by 1000. Now this is Euler's load. If suppose in the problem factor of safety is not given, then this would have been our final answer. But here, as we see in the problem, factor of safety is given as 2. So we have to find out here the safe load, which is P safe. So after this, therefore, safe load will be given by, it is denoted as P safe, and it is equal to Euler's load divided by factor of safety. Euler's load we have found out 13.25 into 10 raised to 3 kilonewton. So dividing this by 2, and therefore P safe value comes out to be 6.62 into 10 raised to 3 kilonewton. So this is our final answer. It means that, here I'll write down a note, that because of Euler's load, the column will buckle, or it will bend. So here, as we have seen, when we had calculated Euler's load, because of Euler's load, the column will be subjected to bending. It will bend in this manner, which is called as buckling. So to avoid this buckling, we need to reduce the value of load here, and that we have reduced by dividing it by factor of safety. So because of Euler's load, the column will buckle or it will bend. So therefore, we calculate safe load to avoid buckling of column. So here in this video, we have seen how to calculate the safe load by using Euler's formula, and here I have written some note which is important to understand the concept behind this problem.